This is Vittorio, an interesting account, who says, massive white pill with two alarms. He said, AI just generated new scientific knowledge. Google and Yale used a 27 billion Gemma model, and it discovered a new cancer mechanism. It predicted a drug. I struggle over the pronunciation of this. Cilmitasertib would only make tumors visible in the immune system if low interferon was present, and lab tests confirmed it. AI made new biological hypothesis, and it was right. How is this not AGI? AGI meaning artificial general intelligence, which is something, you know. Go ahead.
No, just the sentence up above would have benefited from a comma. So they go back up just a little bit more. There we go. The AI predicted that a particular drug would only make tumors visible to the immune system if low interferon was present, period. Lab tests on actual cells then confirmed it. So yep. I only spent 5 minutes looking at this right before, but it's not... Anyway, the prediction wasn't the lab test confirmed it. That's the verification, apparent verification of the prediction.
Yeah, that's the test. So I found this fascinating. I dug into it a little bit, and I'll tell you, you know, I think the details don't matter terribly much, but here's some interesting stuff. What they did was they took cellular data. I think the cellular data in question was the mRNA, messenger RNA transcripts inside of cells. So you've got the DNA, which houses all of the genes of the cell and the organism. And then you've got the mRNA transcripts, which are moving from the cellular genome to the ribosomes to make protein. And the reason that these mRNA transcripts tell you something, you know, all of what's in the mRNA is also encoded in the DNA in a slightly different form. But what's interesting, what the mRNA does for you is it tells you what the cell is actually doing, right? The cell knows how to do lots of things that it never does because it's not that kind of cell. The mRNA tells you what the cell is up to, either because that's the nature of this particular cell or because that's the nature of what the cell is doing at the moment. If the cell is fending off an infection, it will have certain transcripts. You know, if it's responding to damage. So anyway, those mRNA transcripts have meaning. And what they did, super clever, is they figured out how to create sentence-like structures from the mRNA for the purpose of feeding it into the LLMs.
So as a occasional phylogenetic systematist,
yep,
who has thought a lot about how it is that we decide what data to include and what the heuristics are by which we choose which patterns to spend time looking at and which patterns to not spend time looking at, I have to wonder what's in the big black box that is, and we turned the mRNA transcripts into sentences.
Totally. Now, here's what I would say. Absent this result, and I don't know if this result's true or not, I have no reason to doubt it, but... you know, there's lots of fraud out there. This could be fraud, and I can imagine reasons. The AI models are in competition for lots of things, for achievements, but also for investment. And so pretending your AI model is better than it is, you know, there's a reason to do that. So I'm not ruling out the possibility that this is fraud, though, as I read it, everything here is plausible. We turned mRNA into sentence-like structures and then trained an LLM on it, strikes me as, well, were your sentences any good? And what was your rubric? And there's all sorts of questions to be asked.
The result is...
That's it.
The result is that there was a prediction made, and early tests anyway suggest the prediction is borne out.
Right. And in fact, one thing...
And the prediction, knowing nothing here, but presumably the prediction was somewhat risky. The prediction wasn't something obvious.
Well, this prediction is not obvious, and I will get to what the prediction was in a second. But the hypothesis here is weakly novel, I would say.
Okay.
So it's not the slam dunk that I would have looked for, but the point is...
Just to be clear, when I said the prediction is risky, what we want, it's a better test... of a hypothesis when the prediction is so unusual that there's no other possible hypothesis that would result in that prediction being borne out.
Right. Right.
And so like we're hoping for the riskiest prediction that is then, you know, fail to falsify it. And like, oh, wow, that looks like really good support for that hypothesis. So you're saying this hypothesis was, or this prediction was not all that out there.
No, given what you've just said about riskiness, it's risky enough.
Okay.
So that the result is impressive. What okay. it is not is a big leap away from what was known. It's a small leap away from what was known.
Okay.
Okay.
So it's two different things. Two different things. Like is the hypothesis standing stronger in the wake of this test of this prediction, and was the hypothesis, regardless of what the result would be, going to be an important breakthrough if it turned out to be true?
Right.
And the second question appears to be, not really. Well, but the first one is really, you know, the foundation of science, which is, you know, do you have a hypothesis that is testable, and have you tested it, and have you failed to falsify it, and voila, here we go.
Right. Apparently. And although I think we can conclusively dismiss that this is AGI, I think that's an over interpretation of what this is.
Okay.
What it does say is, unless this was a total fluke, which is a possibility, but unless it was a total fluke, we are on the foothill of AI creating hypotheses. And so the point is, give it 5 minutes and you'll get some radical stuff out of it that you wouldn't have spotted on your own. Mm-hmm. And then we're in a whole new universe. So if this paper is what it appears, we are somewhere new, and although not AGI, we are on the foothill of something that probably leads there. So
overall, does this work, as far as you can tell what it is, give you hope or give you pause?
Oh, it scares the crap out of me. Mm-hmm. It's fascinating, but I don't know. I mean, personally, I don't know what I do for a living at the point that AI can train on my work and all sorts of stuff I've never read and outthink me. That's not a good world for me. I don't like that idea at all. And so anyway, that's frightening. But so let me just run through what the hypothesis was and then what the test means. So there is a distinction between cold and hot tumors. Cold and hot is like visible to the immune system. So a cold tumor is a tumor that's growing, it's dangerous, but it is not chemically triggering the immune system to recognize it as foreign and dangerous. And so the immune system is not attacking it. So a cold tumor is bad. A hot tumor is putting out signals that caused the immune system to fight it. And the immune system, we are learning ever more, is responsible for doing away with a lot of would-be cancerous stuff. The immune system is very effective at dealing with this. And when we get a dangerous tumor or a cancer, it's because it has evaded the immune system. So,
how much do we think we know about the difference in origin or developmental trajectory of cold versus hot tumors?
Well, it's not a clean story, but there is a piece of it that is prominent.
Mm-hmm.
That there is selection in the context of the tumor for immune evasion. So
hot tumors can become cold tumors?
That's a good question.
I mean, that sounds like what you just said.
Prediction of the model.
Yeah.
So I'm going to say yes, whether that is a common trajectory,
and, you know,
I don't know.
There's a question. So also, it sounds like a possible prediction of that model is no tumor is either or. All tumors begin as hot tumors, and if the immune system takes care of them before they become invisible to the immune system, great for the body. And if they become cold tumors before the immune system takes care of them, then the body has a problem.
Right. So what these folks did is they asked the AI to find a combination of drugs that would cause a cold tumor to become hot.
Mm.
And What they effectively found was interferon, which is a common cellular product used as a drug, in combination with this other drug, but not in the absence of interferon, would cause the tumor to turn hot, would cause it to become visible. Now, the test that they ran was not in tumorigenic tissue, as far as I can tell. It was in normal tissue. It was not in a living creature. It was on a bench, but it was in living tissue. And they demonstrated that, in fact, you could trigger antigen presentation that would cause the immune system to react in the context of interferon, but not in its absence. So that's what the AI did here. And they claim, and I have no reason to disbelieve them, that they've done a search that says this is not anticipated by anything in the literature. This is not the AI reproducing something we already knew. This is the AI telling us something we didn't know that has potential therapeutic value. Now, the fact that it's being done in cells that aren't tumorous and aren't in a body means that
this we're many steps away from knowing if it will have if it will have therapeutic value, but it has potential therapeutic value. And the claim is that humans didn't know this before.
Right. In the if you, as a graduate student, came to your advisor and you said, hey, check this out. I can get this tissue to trigger the immune system in the context of interferon. That has potential utility against tumors. It'd be a kind of, hey, that's super cool. Keep going. See, see if this pans out moment. So anyway, I think what we've got here is if the work is what it presents itself as, if it is to be taken at face value, it's highly unlikely to be a pure fluke, though that's possible. It is borne out by experiment. That's very cool. And it suggests that AI, it's not AGI because it's not general. It's a highly specific use.
Yeah.
But nonetheless, where is AGI going to come from? It's going to come from cultivating these specific uses, and then voila, it's going to land on your doorstep before you know it. So being on that foothill,
we're going to need better locks
and better bagels.
Oh yeah, sure.
All right. But yeah, I think, so I do think this is, again, if it's all to be taken at face value, this is an important moment because it's the moment at which, you know, the fish starts breathing air. It's like that. It's the foothill of something potentially huge.